What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the Juice Reacts video. It is SCP Saturday, and we are continuing our journey through confinement episode 4, The Girl in the Iceberg. So we're going to react to this right now. Like I said, if you guys do not know, you are getting SCP videos on Saturdays now. We're currently going through the confinement series, and we'll be watching more SCP stuff going forward when we're done with this. But now, we're not going to waste any time, and we're going to jump right into confinement. Let's do this. All right. I still think this intro is really awesome. Beep, boop, boop, beep. Sounds like a gladiator thing. Is it supposed to be all black?
And okay. I don't know who that was or why I have that dream so often.
Is it? Yeah. They're fucking getting high.
One dream I had where Bigfoot could talk. And his entire species used to
just died
over us. And now they want to take over the world again.
That's dumb.
Is 420J not the fattest blunt you've ever smoked?
This is the only blunt I've ever smoked in all my past lives.
I get those two references. You
know, I heard a guy inhaled one of these so hard, he swallowed the joint and temporarily jumped into another dimension. What's the matter, Connor? I thought that'd make you laugh.
Do you know what that means? My dream.
That's a little too Freudian for my taste, Connor.
Well, I'm not a Freud of anything.
Oof. Wow.
God, that was bad. Hurt. Yeah.
The boy is you and the priest is the foundation. There, boom.
Too obvious.
You've been here since you were 3, right? What else did you ever have to worry about other than being hacked, slashed, and drawn in quarters for 19 years?
I don't know. The day the Foundation told me that I had a mom? That kind of bummed me out for a while. Then I got over it when I started masturbating.
Ew.
Those two things aren't connected.
Mr. Connor, report to General Marcus in Psych Wing Sector 5 immediately.
Oh my god, he's going to kill me. Probably twice if I'm late. Bye, Nat. Love you.
You're late, Connor.
Sorry, sir.
What's the matter with your eyes, boy?
I was up all night reading, sir.
Reading what?
Words,
Jesus.
Sir.
At ease, soldier. Now I'm about to brief you on your mission. If you choose to accept it, not that it matters, since you have no choice.
You really like making that joke, sir.
The next 24 hours of your life will be unforgiving. It will involve traveling across national borders and making contact with a previously unknown hostile entity. And furthermore, you are 1/4 Eskimo on your mother's side, correct?
I don't know.
Well, according to the DNA swab you took 4 weeks ago, you share ancestry with the Eskimo people of Nunavik, Canada. This is crucial to the mission.
Oh, well, I guess so, sir. But I think they prefer being called Inuits, not Eskimos.
Oh, you're only 1/4, get over it.
Inuits?
We head out in 10 minutes.
I've never heard that. Although I have heard that Eskimo is a different term nowadays. Every time! Stop putting this music in the... Oh!
Must be a great...
I hate it!
There, sir.
Oh, it is, Mr. Connor. That mountain looked like a breast, doesn't it, Lieutenant?
Sure does.
It's to protect normalcy, so...
There's free music out there you can use!
Regenerative ability.
They already believe in ghosts, aliens, and resurrecting Jews, sir.
We can't hide them all, Connor. We can't hide them all.
I will say, it does make it better. I just don't see how they...
Oh, wow.
They didn't get this taken down sometimes with the music.
I know, it's pretty miserable. Dr. Marlowe's in there. Oh, and he's currently possessed by a ventriloquist dummy. It's a little jarring, but Marlowe's the best marine biologist in North America, so we can't afford to fire or kill him. Good luck, soldier.
Hey, is this the right place? Whoa, hey there, guy.
Oh, God.
I'm Dr. Marlowe, and this is my lab assistant, Dinkelman.
Ech.
You must be the test dummy from the States. Oh, sorry. Mind my wording. Look at me calling you the dummy, right? I know this is a little odd to look at,
A little unusual.
Yep.
There's some water on the floor, the bookshelves unorganized, there's a human arm up my rectum, but trust me, we are professionals and this is a serious research facility. Come this way, friend.
What if you were just to rip off the puppet?
This is SCP-1836. It's an iceberg accompanied by several previously extinct species of hostile aquatic predators, supernaturally piloted by a female of Inuit descent. She seems to really enjoy sinking vessels and feeding their occupants to her porpoise friends. The only people who ever survive these attacks are sailors and fishermen of Inuit descent, like yourself. We're going to need you to make proper contact with her. Sing her a song. She might get Inuit.
The fucking puns. You're dead. Oh, damn. Oh, that would suck. You just keep respawning right there and just keep getting killed. Oh, that's rough.
Kinauvi, Kina, Tukisivinya.
Excuse me?
But you are Inuk, like me.
A quarter, yeah, but I don't speak it.
Are you a spirit?
I don't know. I was sent here to ask questions, like, what's the deal with the ethnic cleansing?
It's not ethnic cleansing. They do not ask for permission to hunt. Now I ask.
Okay.
What are you doing here?
Oh boy. Well, there's this foundation of people who like to capture and learn about things that fall out of the norm, and...
And you're one of them?
God, you're worse than Ferdinand.
Could he speak about it?
I also work technically with them.
You are submitting to their demands like a sled dog?
The term lab rat? Wait, no, I don't. It doesn't matter. Point is, I have no choice. This is all I can do. The sooner you can answer my questions, the sooner I can leave you alone to look for your fingers. Okay, I forgot the questions. What are you doing here? That's a good one.
I was escaping from my father. He wanted me to marry a man named Aguta. This man looked just like you. Very handsome.
Bit weird, but thanks.
But I did not want to marry. I did not want to do many things my father said. My father discovered that Aguta was an evil spirit. We rowed away to escape him, but I fell into the ocean. When I clung to the side of the boat, my father cut my fingers off.
Oof.
Ouch. Guess he really hated spirits. I mean, he must have known you'd become this iceberg whale goddess, right?
The last thing he would do was give me my freedom. It was my will that kept me alive all of these years.
My parents were underprotective of me. And by that I mean they weren't there. Foundation told me that my mother abandoned me in an empty parking lot. No note or whatever. Just left me there in the back seat of an old car, roasting away. Some poor old lady found a car full of dead babies one afternoon, and
damn,
that's when the Foundation got me. From what I've learned about my cellmates and feel-good lifetime dramas, the ultimate goal of a parent is to keep their child safe and happy, even if they're dicks about it.
Could you comb my hair?
Aww. Get cute.
You gotta comb.
Yeah, his funeral was okay. Not the best one I've been to this month. No, he's the guy that confused 173 for 096.
How the fuck do you have a signal up here, Philip?
Look, something's coming.
Just a bird. Not even a cool one like an ostrich.
Well, I've got nothing better to do.
Don't waste your ammo, Lieutenant.
Be careful, Gary. It might have a sharp beak.
Go on. Get. Get.
Oh! Got him.
Connor. That sounds like a woman's name. Ow!
Aitak, sana?
You almost pronounced it correctly. I have never met another orphan before.
Uh-oh. The hell is that? Is that her father?
Hani pizana. Takuna hanakani.
Akavani.
Sana.
I want to be alone. I am not your wife anymore.
I did not come here for that. We have left you alone for thousands of years. You will be dead soon. You cannot deny that. And when that hour comes, your father has asked me to take you to him in the afterlife.
So he could control me there too?
So he could tell you how proud he is of you.
He cut off my fingers.
Yeah, well, dads be like that. He knew that you had a will strong enough to defy death itself, unlike him. He needs you. You don't have to answer his call, but...
Take me to him.
What? The other ones, that was kind of, I mean, that was a good episode, like it had some cool moments, but like I don't think it was the best one out of the other ones that we've seen. I don't know, I just think I enjoyed the other episodes a lot more than this one, also because this was kind of just good, you know, she just took off and there wasn't like a crazy ending or something like that, whereas the other ones felt pretty interesting. I don't know if Connor was just supposed to feel like, oh, he got abandoned again, maybe that was it, like when he was just trying to maybe possibly making a connection with this person. But, yeah, I don't know. Wasn't my favorite out of the ones we've seen so far, but it still was good. So the next one, I don't know if I should be watching the, let's see, because if you go here to Lord Bug, he actually has, there's, like, a trailer for episode 5, and there's a SCP animation, like, special. So I don't know if I should just watch these, or if they're really not even that important for next week, or if I should just watch episode 5 and just skip these, because, you know, I don't know. Let me know. Or maybe, confinement trailer. Like, I don't know. Because we still got episode 5, 6. 6 is actually 2 parts, apparently. And then there's a music video, which I don't probably can't do that because of the music. And then, yeah, 7 is looks like it's 2 parts. And then there's a stop motion thing. So, yeah, I don't know. Let me know the order, if it matters if I watch the special or not. Maybe I'll just combine it with the next video. You guys let me know in that comment section down below. Anyways, if you ladies and gents have not checked out the gaming channel, what are you waiting for? I post every Monday through Friday over there. Sorry. Basically, I almost post as much as I do here on the reaction channel. So if you want more content, go check out the gaming channel. And of course, come hang out on the Twitch channel. It's fun. It's awesome. We've been having some good time. We've been playing Final Fantasy. And we just bought a Minecraft server. So we're going to be starting Minecraft pretty soon. But that is going to be it for this video, ladies and gentlemen. As always, I'm your host, Juice Box. Remember, you wake up in the morning, ask yourself something. But I'm a daily dose of juice. See you guys next time.